focus of today is on the covenant of trust. Do you know that covenants form the backbone of the Bible? We are going to take a look at the covenant that God made with two elderly people. How old is old to you? How do you honor and respect our elders? How should we care for them? What's the oldest person you've ever known? In Genesis 17:1-2, when Abram was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to him and said, "I am God Almighty. Walk before me faithfully and be blameless. Then I will make my covenant between me and you and will greatly increase your numbers." God promised to make Abraham the father of all nations. Abraham and his descendants must obey God. In Genesis 18:11-12, Abraham and Sarah were already very old, and Sarah was past the age of childbearing. So Sarah laughed to herself as she thought, "After I am worn out and my Lord is old, will I now have this pleasure?" Then the Lord said to Abraham, "Why did Sarah laugh and say, 'Will I really have a child? Is anything too hard for the Lord?' I will return you at the appointed time next year, and Sarah will have a son." So is anything too hard for the Lord? God promised Abraham that he and Sarah would have a son. But because Sarah was very old, what would you do if you were 90 years old and God told you that you were going to have a son? We all know that with God, nothing is impossible. As in Luke 1:37, it states that, "For no word from God will never fail." However, Sarah didn't know that. That's why she laughed. She hasn't read the New Testament like you and me. God made a covenant to Abraham and Sarah when Abraham was 100 and Sarah was 90 years old. They finally received what they wanted. In Genesis 21:1-2, "Now the Lord was gracious to Sarah as he had said, and the Lord did for Sarah what he had promised. Sarah became pregnant and bore a son to Abraham in his old age, at the very time God had promised him." What is the longest time that you have waited for something that you really, really wanted? 1 week, 1 month, or 1 year? God has a plan for us. We have to wait it patiently. God made promises to Noah, Abraham, Israel, David, and God made a new covenant with us. Remember the Lord's Supper? As in Luke 22:20, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is poured for you." The new covenant Jesus was announcing that through his death and resurrection, forgiveness of sins would be made available to us all. That's the promise of God. Jesus died for our sins. Whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.